YouTube. How's it going? How are you guys doing? I hope you guys are doing fantastic. If this is your first time checking out Sheila Divine's channel, what is up? I am Amy. If you are returning, welcome back. My gosh, if I could get it together. Okay. So, interesting message for Friday, November 8th. So, if you're ready, I'm ready. Let's get going. So, Oracle cards, we're going to start off the messages from the fairies. So, today you have Express Your Individuality. Allow your true self to shine because you're awesome. Yes, you guys are freaking awesome. Okay. Oh, where my other pile went? Oh, I'll put it there. All right. Love life. The basis of your question involves your romantic life, which is now changing for the better. Can I get an amen? I actually like seeing that love life card because it definitely like really helps people to know that like when you're single, like God is putting you single for a reason. And I feel like a lot of us are on this like journey of being single for a while. And it's kind of like, when is love coming towards me? Like, right. So I sense like the whole, being very like antsy and very like confused and kind of like, I just want it now sort of thing. But I feel like what's happening for today or over the weekend is that just let everything come to you the way that's supposed to. Don't try to force anything this weekend. All right. And I've been seeing this winter card a lot lately, and I've actually been seeing it a lot of the other readings. Some of the readings that I watched for myself, where the winter card keeps coming up for love. So love is definitely going to be, huge this winter for a lot of people. So the answers to your prayers and affirmations are fully realized in the winter months. So maybe the love of your life or the love you've been waiting for is coming in winter. So, and perfect timing. This is the right time for you to move forward. Don't look back no more, guys. It's what's ahead of you is going to be so much better than what you're leaving behind. All right. So let me just put these back. All right. So what I feel is going on for today for you guys is that I feel like some of you are leaving a marriage, some of you are leaving a breakup, some of you are leaving a friendship, and what's happening today is that this is leaving you really sad, which is understandable. It's leaving you really upset. I feel like what you need to do at this time is really keep yourself focused that this is all happening for, you know, a reason, but you got to continue to move forward even though you don't know how to make it through today. So with the Three of Swords coming up as your first card, it just tells me that you guys are really heartbroken right now. You're really upset. You're really in your head. You're really feeling unloved, like unworthy, like here I go again. Just when I find someone, it doesn't work out. And I feel like it has a lot to do with you. I feel like there's some inner issues that you need to really work on. And I feel like until you work on that, you're going to keep getting the same scenarios. So just keep that in mind. But there's definitely a loss here. And it sucks. Like, I don't want to say that. It does get easy. It does get easy, guys. But whatever you're going through, just know you're not alone. Know that this situation is happening for a reason. A breakup can occur for many reasons, right? So to even tap into that is, I'm not even going to tap into that. I'm just going to say that the breakup card is coming up, and that just tells me that two people are separating this weekend or today. So just know that whatever is happening in your life, I do feel like there's a positive side to this, okay? And it, like a Six of Swords comes up right after that. So that just tells me that, you know, it's going to take you a little bit to get out of your shell or your mood or your emotions. But once you do, once you realize that, wait a minute, like maybe our relationship wasn't as solid as I thought. Maybe this person, you know, wasn't as great as I was thinking, but maybe it's something to do with me. Maybe I'm afraid to be alone. That's what I just heard. Okay. So it's about a lot of changes are happening to be today. So move along, move towards this new beginning. You know, a lot of you, this could even be, have happened a couple months ago. That's the other thing that I was picking up, where someone left your life a couple months ago, and it's like it took you a little bit to get out of that emotion or connection, and now you're kind of really seeing yourself being grounded. You're seeing yourself being really focused now, so that's a great feeling to be in, and I feel like a lot of you are just really working on yourselves, which is awesome. I feel like what I said at the beginning, where like everything literally happens for a reason. And even though we don't understand it right now, I feel like for whatever reason, whatever is going on in your life, with the Ace of Swords coming up as that next card, that just tells me you will get the answers you need. You will get the clarity you need. And truth will come out. Truth will always come out. So the only thing that you can do at this very moment today is to let go of anything that's not serving you. And understand that this is happening all for a reason. You're not meant to understand it right now. You're just meant to walk through it. You're meant to walk through this door, this loss, and take it as a loss right now. But don't beat yourself up for it. Don't feel like, oh, well, this person's leaving my life, so I'm guessing I'm going to be single forever. No. There is a reason why this person is leaving your life at this moment. Okay? But there's something with the Eight of Wands coming up as your next card. There is something coming fast towards you. But I feel like what spirit is doing right now, what the universe is doing right now, is they're holding you. They're putting that stop on you right now. I feel like you guys could be afraid to be alone. You could be afraid to, it's definitely afraid to be alone. You know, it's not going to resonate with everyone, but I do feel like it's just in this sense of, you know, maybe this breakup comes out of nowhere. Maybe that's why I'm having a hard time, but maybe this breakup, this marriage ending, it just happens so quick. Like it turns into a fight, it turns into argument, which turns into a fight, which turns into them saying to you, I can't do this anymore. I want a divorce, or I can't do this anymore. I want to break up. Or you're saying it to them. It just, something today is like really fast energy. And I feel like it's going to, just as it's happening, it's going to leave, you know, and there it's this feeling that it doesn't matter what you say or do. It's not in your control. It's not in your hands. It's in the universe hands. It's in spirit's hands. All right. So I feel like what is going on now as that has all fallen apart or all realigning, I guess would be the word, is that you've got to be in this place where you've got to know that you deserve everything, right? And maybe you weren't getting that from this last relationship. Maybe you weren't getting that from that marriage. Maybe the more you try to put into that relationship or marriage, the less you were feeling for yourself. And it's like, when you put all of your energy into other people and you don't put that into yourself, you will get disconnected from yourself. And that is kind of what I'm feeling with this energy, because I feel very disconnected right now. So with the Queen of Cups, it's just saying, you know what? Even though you do not see down there in the future, and all you can see now is like this person leaving and you having to be alone and you having to pick up the sticks or pick up the whatever it is, you know, you can't see the amazing things that the universe has planned for you. But this is that self-healing journey that you guys can start. For a lot of us, we're already on it. We're already working on ourselves. We're already going after what we want. We're already fixing ourselves. We're already, you know, we're not settling anymore. But I'm talking to about the people that are starting these, you know, breakups, or, you know, their marriage is about to end. Like, you are going to be in this place. You're going to feel like a really dark place. And I want you to know that spirit's just saying, you're not in a dark place. You are not broken. You're just moving into a new direction. You're moving into a better place. So this is about happiness right now. This is about going and doing something for you that's going to make you happy. Forgetting about what has happened, forgetting about all the other things that you guys have been dealing with. It's about what's going to make you guys happy right now. You guys have the Strength card, which tells me that it's a lot of patience needing right now. Divine timing is here as well. And a lot of strength. You know, when we get knocked down, it's hard to get back up, right? But you end up pulling yourself back up because you know there's no other way. You have no choice but to do that. So with the Star, that just says that, you know what, you guys are going to realize your worth. You're going to realize your value. You're going to realize that, wait a minute, I need to continue moving on with my life. I need to continue moving on to something bigger and better. So it's about hope. It's about trust. It's about knowing that you've got to bring that power and control back into your life. You can't go find happiness in other people until you are happy with yourself. So it's about bringing that power back. It's about taking care of yourself right now, really asking and manifesting to the universe what you want, owning your choices, owning your decisions, taking your part in why things didn't work out so you're able to heal, you're able to let go. And I mean, you guys will have victory. You will have growth. You know, things will unfold the way they're supposed to. Things will work the way they're supposed to. But I feel like you've got to put yourself back high on that pedestal and don't take yourself off that pedestal, because it's all about you today. All right. So your Oracle card says, Law of Attraction. Each thought is an investment that pays intimate divines. So invest wisely. You have the power to choose your thoughts and align them with love, peace, and harmony. At your request, we will gladly attune your energies to higher frequencies. The angels give you this card as a reminder that the law of attraction can help you improve the situation you're inquiring about. Complaints and worry only attract more of the same, so elevate your thoughts with the help of the angels to attract what you desire. Several times a day, imagine that the situation was presently healed and perfectly manifested. Feel gratitude that is already so in spirit, which is the first part of attracting the material aspects of the situation. Think about your desires and avoid worrying or complaining. Rise up to the level of the type of person you wish to attract. As your spiritual energy increases, you'll find yourself less attracted to lower energies in relationships and situations. This is normal, and the angels can help you deal with these endings and new beginnings. So, yeah. No, there is a loss here. I'm not going to sit here and sugarcoat it. There is a loss here for whoever needs this message today. But with every loss comes a new beginning, a new opportunity, new love, new abundance. So, yeah, you might be in your head about this. You might be like, so tired of starting over, but it's like, you know what, with each start over, you're closer to finding the perfect mate for you, would be the best way that I can put it. All right, guys. So hopefully that helps you guys. Hopefully that makes sense. You guys have yourself a great Friday, and I'll see you guys again soon.